In this video, I'm going to share with you my favorite spaghetti sauce recipe, and at the end, I'm going to show you how I like to freeze individual single servings. That way, when you're hungry or craving spaghetti, you can make it quick and easy any day of the week. The ingredients for my tomato sauce are gonna be 1 pound of ground beef, 1 pound of ground pork, 1 pound of sausage, which we'll remove from their casing. You can go with all beef or all pork, but I wouldn't recommend skipping the sausage. This is what really makes the sauce. 2 onions, which we'll chop, 6 minced cloves of garlic, but we all know you're gonna double that anyways. We'll also dice 1 large green bell pepper, 3 cans of diced tomatoes, 3 cans of tomato sauce, 3 cans of tomato paste, 6 teaspoons of dried oregano, 6 teaspoons of dried basil, 3 tablespoons of brown sugar, 3 bay leaves, and then we'll also add salt and pepper to taste. The first thing we'll do is we're gonna dice the onions. Start off by cutting them in half and trim off the top, leaving the root end. Peel off the skin, and then we'll make small cuts down towards the root. Then we'll lay the onion cut side down and make a few more cuts the other way. Then we'll turn the onion to the side and cut it one more time this way to make nice, small diced pieces. Next, we'll dice our bell pepper. Then we'll mince the garlic. So now that I got all the vegetables ready, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna throw a large pot onto the stove and I'm gonna put that on a medium-high heat. I'll add some olive oil, then throw the onions, bell peppers, and garlic in. I'm gonna season these veggies with salt and pepper and continue to cook them until the onions are soft and translucent. So while I got the vegetables going, I'm gonna go ahead and take these sausages out of their casing. So now that the vegetables are ready, I'm gonna go ahead and add the meat. Add all of the meat and continue to brown everything until it's cooked. Next, add the 3 cans of diced tomatoes, sauce, and tomato paste. Mix this all together until it's combined. After that, you'll add 3 tablespoons of brown sugar, 3 bay leaves, 6 teaspoons of dried oregano, and 6 teaspoons of dried basil. So now that I got everything in the pot, I'm gonna reduce the heat down to low and let it simmer for about 1.5 to 2 hours. You just wanna make sure that you check on it occasionally and give it a stir. So when you're ready to cook the pasta, what I like to do is cook it for a few minutes less than what it says on the back of the box, and then I'll finish it off in the sauce. You want the noodles to be almost al dente. The way you can test it is by grabbing a noodle and chewing it on the back of your teeth, and it should be a soft, but have that little chew. I don't really know how to explain it, but it's got that little bite, that little crunch to it. I like to ladle a few scoops of the sauce into a smaller pot, and then what I'll do is I'll add the cooked noodles to that pot. I'll also incorporate about 1/2 cup of the pasta water and cook it for another 2 minutes. The salty, starchy water not only adds flavor, but helps glue the pasta and sauce together. It'll also help thicken up the sauce. What I also like to do is put the remaining sauce into the refrigerator and I'll let it thicken up overnight. The next day, what I like to do is transfer the sauce into these small 16-ounce deli containers, which we kept from all the times we bought poke. You can find these on Amazon and I'll be sure to put a link in the description. I'll put these in the freezer and basically make big ass spaghetti ice cubes. Whenever I'm craving spaghetti, or after a long day and I'm too lazy to cook, I can just grab one of these out of the freezer. If you run it under hot water for a couple of seconds, the saucicle will release from the container super clean. You can place it in a small saucepan and put that on the stove over medium-low heat to melt it to a simmer. Then you'll just boil pasta and finish it in the sauce as usual. I found that these 16-ounce containers were perfect for individual serving sizes, and if you wanted to make more pasta for more people, you just need to add another saucicle cube per person. There it is, folks, my favorite spaghetti meat sauce. It goes great with just about any pasta. I'm always sure to top it off with some fresh grated Parmesan cheese. You just gotta hit it up with this microplane. If you don't own one of these already, I totally recommend one. Just make sure you get the microplane brand. The Fiberware one is a piece of shit. The sauce has a great meaty tomato flavor. It's a little sweet from the sugar, but the cheese adds a nice salty savory flavor as well.